गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन. सो हियर वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद पार्ट 5 ऑफ द चैप्टर इशू ऑफ शेयर्स. इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस फ्यू ऑफ द प्रैक्टिकल क्वेश्चंस बेस्ड ऑन दोज एडजस्टमेंट्स विच वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन प्रीवियस वीडियो. सो लेट अस बिगिन विद अ क्वेश्चन. द क्वेश्चन सेज ऑन October 1, 2016 A Limited offered 1 lakh shares of rupees 10 each payable as follows. That means 10 is the face value of 1 lakh shares. On application, 3 per share. On allotment, which was due on 1st November 2016, 2 per share. On first call, that is December 1st, 2016, 3 per share. And on second and final call, that is 1 month after first call, that is 1st January 2017. 2 per share. So if we combine the called up value 3 plus 2 plus 3 plus 2, that comes to 10 rupees. And face value is also 10. That means this is the case of issue of shares at par. Applications were received for 1,25,000 shares. So issued shares were 1 lakh, whereas public subscribed for 1,25,000 shares. That means it is the case of oversubscription on 15th October 2016. Applications for 1,20,000 shares were allotted 1 lakh shares and the remaining applications were rejected. So that means out of 1,25,000 applications, we have accepted the applications for 1,20,000 and we have adjusted their excess money towards allotment. That is the excess 20,000 shares application money we have adjusted toward its allotment. And the remaining excess of 5,000 shares were totally rejected. That means 3 rupees of application on 5,000 shares were completely rejected. You have to give the journal entries assuming that all amounts have been received and the company maintains a combined account of application and allotment. That means in this case, you have to prepare the account for both application as well as the allotment altogether. So let us discuss the entry. The first entry is for application received, as we have already discussed. Since the applications were received on 15th October for 1,25,000 shares, so we will record the 3 rupees of application on the entire number of shares applied, that is 1,25,000 shares. And since here we are opening a combined account for application and allotment, therefore we will pass the entry bank account debited to share application and allotment account with the amount of 1,25,000 shares, that is the number of shares applied, multiplied by 3 rupees per share, which is to be called up at the time of application. That means 3,75,000. After the receiving entry of the share application money, now we will pass the entry for application money transferred as well as allotment due altogether. So for share application and allotment, what the entry will be passed is, we will pass it share application money or share application and allotment altogether account debited, that is 5 lakh to share capital account 5 lakh. That is 3 rupees of application and 2 rupees of allotment on actual number of shares issued, that is 1 lakh. Then after that, the excess money is to be rejected on 5,000 shares altogether. That is 3 rupees of application will be rejected on 5,000 shares, and for application rejected, the entry will be share application and allotment account debited to bank account 5,000 into 3, that is 15,000, as we have already discussed. So these are the entries for application money received, application money transferred, allotment money due, and excess money rejected. And remember one thing, the application money will be transferred on the date when the allotment will become due. And obviously, the day allotment becomes due, number of shares are allotted in on this very same day, we will be rejecting the excess money also. Since here we are opening the same account for application allotment, therefore the excess allotment money is already adjusted. Now we'll pass the entry for receiving the allotment money. As you can see, The allotment money will be received when the first call has fallen due. That is on December 1st, the first call is becoming due, and November 1st. Before the first call is due, we'll pass the receiving entry for application, which was the due date November 1st. And as you can see, we have passed the receiving entry of allotment as bank account debited to share application and allotment account, and the amount here is 1,40,000, whereas allotment due is 2 rupees on 1 lakh, so that makes 2 lakh rupees. But why we have passed 1,40,000? Because if you remember, the applications were received for 1,25,000 shares, out of which we have allotted or we have adjusted the excess money of 1,20,000 shares. So if you see the note below this, the format of journal, amount due on allotment is 1 lakh shares into 2 rupees, that is 2 lakh. But you have already received the excess money during application, which you will be adjusting in the allotment. That is excess received on application, that is on 20,000 shares, because 5,000 you rejected. So 3 rupees you had already received during the application money, that is 20,000 into 3, that is 60,000. So this you will be adjusting in the allotment itself, which is coming to 1,40,000. So that means actually now you will be receiving only 1,40,000 rupees as per the allotment money. So you will pass the entry bank account debited to share application and allotment account 1,40,000. Then we will pass the due entry for the first call, as in the similar manner we used to pass 3 rupees of first call, that is share first call account debited 3 lakh, 1 lakh into 3 to share capital. And then we will be passing the receiving entry, since the question says that we have to assume all the due money was received. So bank account debited 3 lakh to share first call account 3 lakh. Then secondly, 1 month after the first call, that is January 1st, 2017, second call was due. So share second and final called account debited to share capital account 2 rupees on 1 lakh shares, that is 2 lakh. And it was subsequently received on the same day, January 1st, bank account debited to share second and final call account. So I hope this question is clear to you, children. This is the case of oversubscription. Moving towards the next question, the question says Dinesh Limited issued 5,000 shares of rupees 100 each at par, that is 100 face value, payable as follows: on application 25, on allotment 25, on first call 20, and on final call 30. Anil holding 100 shares failed to pay the amount of allotment and first call on his shares, and his shares were forfeited after the first call. That means Anil, the holder of 100 shares, did not pay the 25 rupees of allotment and 20 rupees of first call. That means 45 rupees on 100 shares was not paid by Anil, and therefore his shares were forfeited after the first call. Whereas Sunil, who was holding 200 shares, failed to pay the amount due on final call, that is 30 rupees on 200 shares, and his shares were also forfeited after the final call. You have to show the entries in the cash book and the journal of the company. And we know, we remember the rule that when we are preparing the cash book, we need not record the receiving entry, because receiving entries are directly posted in the cash book, and we have to just pass the entry for basically rest of the entries, arrears, due, forfeiture, etc. So starting with the first one, application was obviously paid by everybody. So first of all, we will record the application received in the cash book on the debit side to share application account 25 rupees on 5,000 shares, that means 1,25,000 rupees. And after the application money is received, we will pass the transfer entry for the application, that is share application account debited 1,25,000 to share capital account 1,25,000. After transferring the application money, we will pass the allotment due entry, and the entry will be share allotment account debited 1,25,000 to share capital account 1,25,000. So that means 1,25,000 should have been received, was to be received on the allotment, but it was not received, because if you see, Anil, who was holding 100 shares, he did not pay the allotment. Neither he paid the allotment nor he paid the first call. So that means we have not received 25 rupees on 100 shares. That means we have not received 2500 of allotment. So 2500 is the calls in arrear. So that means ultimately we have received only 1,22,500. That is 1,25,000 minus 2,500. So therefore, on the debit side of cash book, we have shown two share allotment account, that is actual allotment money received, 1,22,500. Now we will pass the entry for the first call due. So share first call account debited. We know that first call was due with 20 rupees on 5,000 shares. That means 1 lakh. Two share capital account, 1 lakh. That means 1 lakh was to be received on first call. But again, as we have seen in the question, Anil did not pay the first call also. So that means 20 rupees on 1,000 was not received. That means out of 1 lakh, 2,000 was not received. That means ultimately we have received only and only 98,000, which we have shown on the debit side of the cash book as two share first call account, 98,000. Now, before proceeding with the second call due, we remember that just after the first call, the shares of Anil was forfeited. So that means we will pass the forfeiture entry for Anil, and the entry will be share capital account debited. And we know that share capital account is debited with the called up value excluding premium. So in this case, premium is not there, and called up value is 25 rupees of application plus 25 rupees of allotment plus 20 rupees of first call, because second call is not called from Anil. Immediately after the first call, his shares are forfeited. That means 70 rupees were called from the shareholder Anil. So 70 rupees is the called up value on the number of defaulting shares. That means 100 shares. So 100 into 70, that means 7,000 we have debited to share capital account. Then we credit two calls in arrears account. So if you have opened the calls in arrears account, directly you will show two calls in arrears account, 4,500, 2,000 of first call and 2,500 of allotment. If you have not shown, not opened, just in like in this question, so you will show it separately. Two share allotment account, 2,500, two share first call account, 2,000. And then two share forfeiture account, in this you will show the amount which is actually received from the defaulting shareholder. So defaulting shareholder has only paid the 25 rupees of the application. So 25 rupees on defaulting share, that is 100 shares. So we will credit two share forfeiture account with 2,500 rupees. Now the forfeiture entry of Anil has been passed. Now we will do the final call. So this is very important, just pay very clearly, just pay attention to it, that you have to pass the final call due entry, and the final call will be due by 30 rupees, but it will not be due on 5,000 shares because 100 shares have already been cancelled. So this 30 rupees of final call will be due on only 4,900 shares. So share final call account debited to share capital account, 1,47,000. How we have got it? 4,900 shares. Why? Because 100 shares have already been cancelled, forfeited into 30 per share. And the question says that Sunil, who was holding 200 shares, failed to pay the amount due on final call. That means 30 rupees on 200 shares. That is 6,000 was not received on the final call. So that means if 1,47,000 was to be received, but 6,000 has not been received, that means final call you have received only 1,41,000, which you can see on the debit side of the cash book as 1,41,000 amount. Now immediately after the final call, the shares of Sunil also were forfeited. So here we will pass the entry share capital account debited with the called up value excluding premium. So called up value in this case was, as we know, that he was called the entire money. So 100 rupees was the called up value on number of defaulting shares. That means 200 shares. So 100 on 200 shares, that means share capital will be debited by 20,000 rupees two call scenarios if you have opened. Otherwise, to share final call account, that is 6,000 rupees. He did not pay the final call of 30 on 200 shares. To share forfeiture account, the amount which he has already paid. So he has already paid the 70 rupees of application, allotment and first call on 200 shares. That means 14,000 he has already paid. So this is the forfeiture entry of Sunil. The note number one which is given here is, when cash book entries are asked in the question, all cash transactions are to be recorded in cash book. Other non-cash transactions should be entered in the journal. This we have already discussed. So I hope this question is clear to you children. Moving towards the next question. Question number 39. You have to pass journal entries for the forfeiture and reissue in the following cases. Number 1, X Limited forfeited 700 shares of Ashok of 10 each. 8 rupees was called up, on which he had paid 5 per share. Out of these, 500 shares were reissued for 9 per share as fully paid. So 8 rupees was called up, the shares were reissued at 9 rupees per share as fully paid, 700 shares were forfeited, out of which only 500 shares were reissued, and the amount which was paid on the forfeited shares were 5 rupees. So you have to pass the entry for forfeiture as well as the reissue. So let us begin. The first entry for Ashok. First entry is for the forfeiture. So share capital account debited with the called up value, which is already given in the question, 8 rupees on 700 shares, that is 5600. Two call scenario. Now the question is saying 5 was paid. So if 5 was paid, that means 3 was not paid. That means 3 is call scenario. So two call scenarios account credit will be credited. 700 into 3, that is 2100. And two share forfeiture account, 700 into 5, which is actually paid, that will be 3500. Now these shares are reissued at 9 per share as fully paid. Now whenever the word fully paid is given, you have to compare the price with the face value. Whenever the word fully paid is given, you have to compare the price with the face value. So if 9 rupees fully paid is given, you have to compare it with the face value. Face value is 10. That means you are reissuing the shares at a discount of 1 rupee. And maximum discount which you can give, which is already received on the forfeiture of share. And another very important point regarding reissue is that whenever the shares are reissued at discount, the amount of discount given on reissue will be adjusted from the amount already retained while forfeiting the shares in the share forfeiture account. So therefore, in this case, we will pass the entry bank account debited with the amount actually received, that is 9 rupees on 500 shares which are reissued, 4500. Then the discount of 1 rupee on 500 shares will be adjusted from share forfeiture account. So share forfeiture account debited 500 to share capital account 5000 with the face value. So this is, these are the entries related to reissue and forfeiture. Now we have already learned in the previous video that whatever excess money of the reissued shares are left in the forfeiture account, that will be transferred to capital reserve, but only those, that amount of reissued share will be transferred which is actually reissued. If the shares are not reissued, the amount will not be transferred. So how much money of share forfeiture account is to be transferred to capital reserve on these 500 shares, which you can see here, that profit on 700 shares which was transferred to share forfeiture account is 3500. Hence, profit on 500 shares is 3500 divided by 700. That means whichever, that is the coming to per share profit, multiplied by 500, that is number of shares reissued. So that means on 500 reissued shares, the actual profit is 2500. Out of this 2500, 500 rupees you have already adjusted while giving the discount. So that means only 2000 belongs to this category of reissued shares, which will be transferred to capital reserve. So for transferring the excess money to capital reserve, the entry will be share forfeiture account debited 2000 to capital reserve account 2000. Working we have already seen. Then second category of the question is T Limited forfeited 400 shares of 10 each, 6 called up for non-payment of first call of per share. Out of these, 300 shares were immediately reissued at 5 per share. Now, 400 shares were forfeited, the face value of which was 10, but 6 rupees was called up and first call per share was not paid. Out of these, 300 shares were immediately reissued. Now, if 6 was called up and these shares were reissued at 5 rupees, how will we pass the entry? Let us see. So now the entry for forfeiture will be share capital account debited with the called up value, that is 6 rupees on 400 shares, 2400, and the first call of 2 rupees was not paid, that means 2 calls in arrear if you have opened, otherwise 2 share first call account, 2 rupees on 400 share, that means 800, 2 share forfeiture. So if 6 was called up, 2 is not paid, that means 4 is paid, so we will credit 2 share forfeiture account, 400 shares into 4 rupees, that is 1600. Now out of this 400 shares, 300 shares were immediately reissued at rupees 5 per share, and if we compare it with the called up value of 6 rupees, that means 1 rupee is the discount given, and this discount will be adjusted from share forfeiture account. So the entry for reissue will be bank account debited 1500, that is 300 shares into 5 rupees per share. Then 1 rupee of discount will be adjusted, share forfeiture account will be debited, that is 300 shares into 1, 2 share capital account with the face value, that is your total 1800, that is 5 rupees into 300, which you are actually reissuing at. Then again the excess of money on this reissued shares in share forfeiture account will be transferred to the capital reserve, so the entry for which will be share forfeiture account debited 900 to capital reserve account 900. And how you have got 900? Just have a look at the note number 2. Profit on 400 shares was 1600, which you have transferred to share forfeiture account. So if profit on 400 shares was 1600, therefore profit on 300 shares will be 1600 divided by 400 multiplied by 300. That means the profit on 300 shares will be 1200, out of which 300 you have already adjusted by giving the discount. So remaining surplus of 900 will be transferred to the capital reserve. Now the next question, the case says Z Limited forfeited 300 shares of 100 each, on which first call of 20 per share was not received. The second and final call of 30 per share has not yet been called. That means we have called only the first call. Out of these, 200 shares were reissued as 70 paid up for 55 per share. Now, so that means out of 100, we have not called 30 rupees. That means we have called up only 70 rupees. 70 per share has been called up. So how, and 20 of first call was not paid. So if 20 of first call was not paid, that means remaining 50 was paid, and out of these 300 shares, 200 shares were reissued as 70 paid up for 55 per share. So have a look at the entry. The last entry in this case, in this format, in this slide, share capital account debited with the called up value of 70 on 300 shares, that is 21,000. To share first call, the call scenario, if you have opened the calls in arrear account, 20 rupees on 300 shares, that is 6000. So if 70 was called up, 20 was not paid, that means 50 was paid. So to share forfeiture account, 50 rupees on 300 shares, that is 1500 shares. Now these shares were reissued at 55 rupees, that means 15 rupees was given as a discount. 55 rupees, it was these were reissued at, that means 70 was called up and 55 was reissued, that means 15 rupees has been given as discount, which will be adjusted from the share for future account. So here bank account will be debited 11,000. That means 200 shares into 55 rupees each. Then share for future account will be debited with 3,000, that is discount amount of 15 rupees on 200 shares, to share capital account, that is 55, that is 14,070 rupees on 200 shares. Now excess of profit on these reissued shares, that is 200 shares, will be transferred to capital reserve account. So therefore the entry will be passed as share for future account debited 7,000 to capital reserve account 7,000. And how we have got the amount of 7,000? You can see in note number 3, profit on 300 shares is 15,000. So if profit on 300 shares is 15,000, that means profit on 200 shares will be 15,000 divided by 300 into 200, that means 10,000. And out of this 10,000, loss on reissue or discount on reissue of 3,000 has already been adjusted. That means surplus which is left to be transferred to capital reserve is 7,000. So I hope this question is clear to you children. Now the next question says X Limited issued a prospectus offering 2 lakh shares of 10 each at rupees 14 per share. That means these shares are issued at premium. On application 4 rupees, on allotment 6 rupees including premium of 4, on first call 3 and on final call balance. That means 4 plus 6 plus 3 is coming to 13 rupees. And the shares are actually issued at 14 rupees. That means 1 rupee is the balance amount which will be called up at the time of final call. Dinesh, the holder of 1000 shares, did not pay the amount due on allotment and first call. So that means this is the case of forfeiture when the shares are issued at premium and premium money is not received. So Dinesh, who was holding 1000 shares, did not pay the allotment or the first call. His shares were forfeited, and out of these 1000 shares, 400 shares were immediately reissued, credited rupees 9 paid for 8.40 per share. That means 9 rupees was paid on this and it was reissued at 8.4. that means it was reissued at discount. So the discount amount of 60 paise will be adjusted from the share for future profit. Final call was made afterwards and it was duly received. Obviously final call will be will not be made on 1000 shares because these are already cancelled. Show the entries in the cash book and the journal of the company. And if we are preparing the cash book, so we will not pass any cash entries in the journal because these will directly be recorded in the cash book. So first of all, let us pass the application received entry in the cash book. So application money of 4 rupees was received on 2 lakh shares. So on in the cash book, on the debit side, we have shown 2 share application account 8 lakh rupees. And this amount of 8 lakh will be transferred to share capital, for which we have passed the entry share application account debited 8 lakh to share capital account 8 lakh. Then we will pass the entry for allotment due. So allotment due is 6 rupees, out of which 4 rupees is the premium and 2 rupees is the face value. So the allotment due entry will be share allotment account debited with 6 rupees on 2 lakh shares, that is 12 lakh, to share capital account with the value excluding premium, that is 2 rupees on 2 lakh shares, that is 4 lakh, and to securities premium reserve account. This will be credited separately with the amount of premium, that is 4 rupees on 2 lakh shares, that is 8 lakh rupees. Now we have to see whether we have received the entire amount of allotment or not. So we have seen that Dinesh, a holder of 1000 shares, did not pay the amount due on allotment. So that means 6 rupees on allotment on 1000 shares, that is 6000, was not received. So if out of 12 lakhs 6000 was not received, that means amount which we have received on allotment, you can see on the debit side of the cash book, to share allotment account is 11,94,000. That means 6 rupees on 1,99,000 shares, because on 1000 we have not received the allotment money. And if you are opening the call scenario account, then you will pass the entry for call scenarios also. in that case. Then you will pass the entry for first call due. So share first call account debited with the first call money, that is 3 rupees on 2 lakh shares, so 6 lakh, to share capital account 6 lakh. Now you have to see whether you have received the first call money or not, and we know that Dinesh has not paid the first call also on 1000 shares. So first call also, as you can see on the debit side of the cash book, we have received only on 1,99,000 shares, because we have not received it on the on 1000 shares of Dinesh. So we have debited to share first call, we have shown on the debit side 3 rupees on 1,99,000 shares, that is remaining shares 5,97,000. And immediately after the first call, the shares of Dinesh were forfeited. And you can see the forfeiture entry. And since this is the case when the shares are issued at premium and the premium money is also not received, so here we will debit the share capital account, will be debited with the called up value, and the called up value for Dinesh will be the amount of application, the amount of allotment, and the amount of first call excluding premium. So that is 9 rupees. That means 4 of application, 2 of allotment, and 3 of first call. That is 9 rupees. So 9 rupees on defaulting share, that is 1000. 9,000 will be debited, and since we will not receive the premium because the shares are forfeited, so therefore the premium which we have credited needs to be written back. It will be debited securities premium reserve account with the amount of premium 4 rupees on defaulting share, that is 1,000. So 4,000 will be coming to. Then to share allotment account, or if you have opened call scenario, then you will write to call scenario's account. If you have not opened call scenario, then you will write to share allotment, that is outstanding allotment money 6,000, 6 rupees on 1,000 shares. And to share first, again, because premium is not received, so here allotment will be including premium. To share first call, 3 rupees on first call, that is 3,000. And to share forfeiture, the amount which you have already received. So you have already received 4 rupees of application from Dinesh. So 4 rupees on 1,000 shares, that means 4,000. So this will be the entry for forfeiture. Then immediately these shares are reissued. Out of these shares, 400 shares are actually reissued at 8.4 rupees per share. That means 0.69 was paid or called up. Again, fully paid or paid word is given. We'll compare it with the called up value. So called up value was 9 rupees, and these are reissued at 8.4. That means 0.60 or 60 paise, we can say. That is the amount of discount which will be adjusted from share forfeiture account. Anyhow, we will pass the receiving entry in cash book directly. So as you can see on the debit side of cash book, to share capital account 8.4 rupees on 400 shares, that is 3,360. And the amount of 60 paisa which you have given as a discount will be adjusted from share forfeiture, because this is the case of reissue. So share forfeiture account debited 240 rupees, to share capital account 240 rupees, that is loss of 60 paisa on reissue of 400 shares, 400 into 60 paisa. Then after the shares are reissued, the excess, the surplus of this profit in forfeiture account will be transferred to the capital reserve account. Now, if you remember, in the previous entry, we have transferred 4,000 in the share forfeiture account. So, if 4,000 is the profit on 1,000 shares, so the profit on 400 shares will be 4,000 upon 1,000 into number of shares reissued, that is 400. So that will be the surplus of 1600, out of which 240 you have already adjusted as a discount. So remaining surplus of 1360 will be transferred to the capital reserve account. So these are the entries related to reissue and forfeiture. Then you will pass the entry for final call due. So final call due, again, it will not be due on 2 lakh shares now, because 1000 has already been forfeited. So now final call will be due only on 1,99,000. In fact, 400 shares will be there, because these are actually reissued. So now the final call will be ड्यू ऑन 1,99,400 शेयर्स of 1 rupees. So that means the due entry of final call will be share final call account debited 1,99,400 to share capital account 1,99,400, and final call is duly received. So in the cash book on the debit side you will write to share final call account 1,99,400 shares into 1 rupee each, that is 1,99,400. So I hope the entries are clear to you children. So in this additionally, I have prepared the balance sheet also. As you can see, balance sheet of X Limited as at current year amount, previous year amount, note number, particulars. In the particulars, you have seen equity and liabilities, shareholder funds, share capital, reserves and surplus. And you can see that share capital note number 1 and 2 is given. The net amount of 19,96,400 is given for share capital, and 7,97,360 is given for reserve and surplus. And asset side, cash and cash equivalents is given in note number 3, 27,93,760. So you can see the working of it. This is the notes to account, point number 1. Share capital, again, now in this I have not shown authorized, because I wanted to remind you that authorized is to be shown separately. First you will show the authorized, no doubt, no matter if it is mentioned specifically in the question or not. Then you will write the issued capital, 2 lakh shares of 10 each, that is 20 lakh. Then you will write subscribed and fully paid up, that is 1,99,400 shares of 10 each, that is 19,94,000. Plus you will add the share forfeiture 2,400, because calls and earnings we have already adjusted, because it is already forfeited. Then reserve and surplus, you have shown 1,360 for capital reserve, securities premium reserve of 7,96,000, and cash and cash equivalents, that is the cash at bank balance, which you have already calculated from cash book. So this is the question. I hope it is clear to you children. Now this is the assignment. Based on this part, you have to solve practical question number 17, 19, 20, 28, 30, 32 and 33 from the chapter Company Accounts, Issue of Shares from your accounts book, volume 2 by D.K. Goyal children. Do complete your work, practice as many questions as you can, and this is a very important chapter children. In the last part, in the next part will be the last part. In that we will be discussing one more adjustment, and on the basis of that we'll be discussing few of the questions. Thank you children, take care.